turns out that in evolutionary timeframes, if you look back over hundreds of millions of years of evolution, there's evidence for inflammation dating as far back as there's evidence of life. So inflammation evolved in the early stages of life. That means that evolutionary pressure also evolved mechanisms to control inflammation so there wouldn't be too much. So the simple answer is that the inflammatory reflex is signals that travel up and down in the vagus nerve. When inflammation occurs, these signals travel up into the brain, telling the brain there's inflammation in the body. And the brain responds by sending signals back down the vagus nerve to stop or resolve the inflammation. And that up and down signal, inflammation present, inflammation off, is the inflammatory reflex. And understanding that provides a model to dissect out very exquisite and specific molecular and neurophysiological mechanisms. And we've actually now, after 20, 25 years of working on this problem, we've actually been able to isolate individual nerve fibers that secrete a neurotransmitter called acetylcholine that travel from the brainstem down into the area outside of the spleen. And these signals are electrical signals, which are converted to chemical signals, acetylcholine. And these are the signals that switch off the white blood cells and stop inflammation. So the inflammatory reflex is like the brakes on your car. It's the brakes on the immune system that slows down inflammation. And the vagus nerve is the conduit, the cable that carries those signals to turn off the inflammation.
All right. That was a great explanation.